Hi everyone, in this video we'll go through one marker problems related to ratio and proportions. So we'll go through these questions one by one. The third proportional of 6 and 24 is, now what is third proportional? Third proportional means the last term, right? You have a is to b in proportion to b is to x, right? This x, the last term is what you have to find whenever they say third proportional. How do you find that? So you will have to assume that a is to b is in proportion with b is to x. Now 6 and 24, that means the first term is 6, second term is 24. Here third term is also 24, fourth term is what you have to find. So you will use the proportion formula. What is that? 6 into x, right? The extremes, multiply the extremes. 6 into x is equal to 24 into 24, the middle terms. You multiply that. So 6x is 24 into 24. Therefore, you can find x. Similarly, another example. Find the third proportional of 4 and 6. So, 4 is to 6. 6 is to x. So, the fourth term is what you have to find. Don't confuse. Third proportional doesn't mean third term. Third proportional means fourth term. Again, multiply the extremes, right? And equate it to the middle terms. So, 4x is 6 into 6, which is 36. Therefore, x is 9. Another one, third proportional of 3 and 12. So 3, 12, 12, right? Now you find the value of x. So 3 into x is equal to 12 into 12, 144. 3x is 144, so thereby x is 48. Now here, find the value of x if 32 is to x is 75 is to 50. What do you do? You'll have to use a proportion formula, right? Multiply the middle terms, equate it to the product of the extremes. 32 into 50. 32 into 50 is equal to 75x and find the value of x. Similarly, here also, you'll have 20 into 3 equal to 5 into x. 5x is 20 into 3, which is 60, thereby x is 12. Find the fourth proportional. Now, fourth proportional. Here also, you have to find the last term only. Only difference is, here you have all three terms given, right? 4, 5, 24, fourth term you have to find. Now, this is the difference between third proportional and fourth proportional. In third proportional, the middle two terms are same. Here, if you notice, in third proportional, middle two terms are same. But in fourth proportional, the middle terms are different. So, you'll get 4, 5, 24. 4, 5, 24, the fourth term you have to find. Here, another example. Right, you have to find fourth term. 6, 14, 15. So, multiply 14 into 15 and multiply 6 with x. So, 6x. Thereby, you'll find value of x. Now, very important, find the triplicate ratio. Triplicate ratio means find the cube, right? That is to the power 3. That is triplicate ratio to the power 3. So, 3 is to 5 means 3 cube. 3 into 3 into 3, which is 27. 5 into 5 into 5, which is 125. Find the duplicate ratio. Duplicate means 2. Duplicate means 2. So, 5 into 5. 5 square. 25. 3 into 3, 9. Now another example. Triplicate ratio of 2 is to 3 is 2 cube, 3 cube, which is 8 is to 27. Now additional topics, right? What is subtriplicate? Triplicate is 3 cube. Subtriplicate would be cube root. Cube root. Remember, it's root. Right? So 27 is to 125. What is subtriplicate of this? You have to take cube root of 27. What is cube root of 27? 3. That means 3 into 3 into 3 is 27. What is cube root of 125? 5. Because 5 into 5 into 5 is 125. Like that. Now what is subduplicate? Subduplicate means square root. Square root. Here it was cube root. Here it is square root. What is square root of 25? It's 5. What is square root of 9? It's 3. Additional concepts again. Antecedent and consequent. Antecedent and consequent. If you're given a ratio 2 by 3, what is antecedent? This is called as the antecedent and this is called as the consequent, right? 2 is the antecedent, denominator is called as the consequent. So with this, we've come to the end of this particular video. If you like this video, do press a like and share it. Thank you.